Hey everybody! Welcome back to Northern Lion Plays the Binding of Isaac Rebirth. I think the time has finally come for us to check out hard mode. I'm just gonna play, you know, as Isaac, just to normalize things a little bit. Here's what I know about hard mode. It gives you that weird little pentagram type thing under your keys. Everything is splotched in like a little bit of raspberry jam. See today, TJ4NWJ8Z, depending on your perspective. It don't matter. I'm gonna spoil it for you. You think it's Z, you think it's... Isn't it weird how in Canada they say Z? It's not weird at all. It is a very slight difference between two countries who are otherwise similar in almost every way. In any case, here's what I know about hard mode. You fight a lot more champions. The champions are not necessarily likely to drop more consumables. That's a good start. They're not necessarily likely to drop more consumables the way normal champions are. Other things that I know about hard mode. Consumable drops are crazy low. So as I understand it, you really want to be conservative with your usage of keys, shall we say. These spiders are like perfect at getting outside of this weird little valve here. Gee, like I can't get away from them here. Like, I don't really necessarily want to use a bomb to get that situation, but maybe I will. Tell you what, we'll take Dr. Fetus, even though it's not so good anymore. Consumables are supposedly hard to come by on hard modes, so it seems to make sense that an item like Dr. Fetus or Fetus in a Jar would actually benefit us a great deal here. Similarly, the Lover's card. We've done pretty good at taking care of our consumables thus far. Now, I'm not getting cocky by any stretch of the imagination. That was a really, you know, productive bit of damage that I took there, by the way, of course. Dr. Fetus is a pretty bad item, all things considered. Like, generally speaking, it's substantially worse than it used to be in vanilla, to the point where a lot of people consider it kind of a run ruiner. Can you really just not blow up a golden poop? Oh, you can, it's just not easy. We'll do what we have to do, because that's, again, consumables hard to come by. I'm interested to see how this works out. I know we have to grind out some challenges on hard to get everything in the game, so I saw a comment that was basically like, you can get items on hard mode. You don't have to just get them on normal mode. And I was like, yeah, it's a good point. We can kind of get two birds stoned at once here. I know what you're saying there, dickfucker 71. You thought I was going to say 69, as if that was not based on a real person. So yeah, if you're watching this and you're like, hard mode, but you got Fetus in a Jar, GG. Remember that Fetus in a Jar kind of sucks now. The only time I've had it is when I was playing as Azazel. These are champion enemies, I guess. We were playing as Azazel, and we got Fetus in a Jar, and then it like completely nerfed the damage that we were doing with our weird little brimstone shot. That was not our second secret room. That was just our regular secret room, wasn't it? It appears that that is indeed the case. Ooh, don't come over here, friend. Swallowed Penny gives us a chance to pick up money when we get hit. Are you kidding me that that bomb fly survived one bomb to his face? That seems unlikely to me. But yeah, it's hard. We ended up getting that Azazel run saved because we ended up picking up Mom's Knife. It was like Brimstone, then Fetus in a Jar, or yeah, Fetus in a Jar, then Mom's Knife all in the same run. Those were the days. Alright, second secret room. Work with me, baby. It's an eternal heart, so we'll not pick it up yet. You know, maybe I'm being overly paranoid about a lack of consumables, but I'm concerned about that. And I think that maybe a happy medium would be if we were able to pick up, say, the crate here. That might make our life a little bit easier, you know? Nobody's gonna say the crate is their favorite item in the Binding of Isaac or the Binding of Isaac Rebirth. Either way, though, might not be the worst thing in the world for us to pick up. Remote detonator would be pretty good, but I think we're probably better off just keeping our D6 to kind of mitigate any other problems. Well, so far, hard mode doesn't seem that hard at all. Is that Blue Famine's normal tell? I always thought he kind of like sucked in a little bit first before it happened. I guess we shouldn't have worried too much about getting the crate. Hey, maybe this can be a run where we can get like Bandage Girl or something like that. Probably not, huh? Okay. Let's, take this. No keys, which is not unexpected. You know what? Maybe I'll go to that last room that we have available here. Because if we get a key, our shop would be awesome to visit. But my hunch is that we'll be able to visit the next shop anyway. Just by being able to bomb our way through a secret room or something like that. It can happen. It can also not happen. You know, those are the two ways that it could go. But I'm relatively pleased with this first floor. We have basically unlimited bombs. Picked up one extra HP. A spirit heart that protects our interests for a deal with the devil on the next floor. I don't mind it, to be honest with you. If we can replace Fetus in a Jar, maybe we'll want to do that. But for now, I'm enjoying my time here on this hard mode run. I don't understand what everyone's so complaining about. Secret rooms have really become, in my opinion, a lot worse. On average. A lot less functional on average, let's put it that way. Maybe worse isn't the way I want to describe it, because sometimes you can still get amazing items, but on the whole, or on average, I find them not necessarily as useful. You used to be able to bank on like 6 cents on average. You don't get that anymore. By the way, I know that some people are like, hard mode isn't even the way that the game is meant to be played. Like, the fact that there's so few consumables makes it like really... I think we'll reroll that. Yeah, that seems like an okay pickup for us. Makes it like unbalanced. That's totally fine. But we don't really have much of a choice in the matter, you know? We gotta do the hard mode stuff in order to get, real Platinum God. It's a phrase that I've heard bandied about a lot. Real Platinum God. I don't know what real Platinum God is, but I would like to get it at some point. We got all the time in the world, hopefully. But for now, let's just enjoy ourselves here. By the way, just because, you know, I play a lot of Isaac, I would never expect me to default to hard mode for these runs. Like, long term, I think normal mode is, it's where my heart lies here. There's Swallowed Penny actually having an impact. We could ruin our deal with the devil chances here. These spiders, man. That's why remote detonator would be really nice, but we'd have to get rid of our D6, of course, in order to make that happen. Spirit hearts, please. Or one black heart. Or, we might as well. I mean, lots of red hearts. That's pretty useful. We can save our lover's card for a little bit later. And don't let the spiders get close. We can keep the spiders at bay. Your life might be okay. And of course, we just spawn more spiders. Get ready to just, like, exit into the boss room. Yeah, okay. Pin. Oh my god. So we got super lucky there. We deserved to take damage, but instead, not only did we not take damage, we actually did a ton of damage to Pin, I think by way of, like, attack fly. Or it might have even been closer. It might have been the bandage that did it, but man, that was close. We probably did not deserve to get out of that as easily as we did. Now, Pin is not as much of a cakewalk as you might think with Dr. Fetus. You gotta be careful, too, because when he hits those bombs, they get, like, twice as much momentum as you would expect. There we go. He's dead. We got HP. We gotta deal with the devil. And, I think I'm gonna take both of these, honestly. I know that this will ruin... No, it won't. We just fire a lot more often now. And probably have extra damage. But I know that, our bombs do scale damage-wise with our damage. So we might as well pick that up as well. It's a bit risky, I'll admit. But hey, I want to take every available advantage because it appears that we won't really have a great chance of actually getting to our item room or our shop ever. So this is okay, I guess. The spirit heart is valuable, I'll admit. Really just no keys, huh? I do want to blow those up, but it seems problematic. Oh, thank you. Okay. So, I can't help but feel that we're probably better off going to the shop, huh? Pretty good chance that we'll find a key on the shop. Even if we don't, you know, we have an item presumably showing up on the shop. I don't know. We'll go to the shop first. It's really a shame that the rooms weren't adjacent to any of these secret rooms here. Let's see what we got, though. There's no key, but there is Champion Belt. And I feel like Champion Belt is kind of like a no-brainer pickup for us in this situation. I'll buy the Spirit Heart, too, just in case. And that pill could be bombs or key, I'll admit, but I'm not going to chance it. I feel like Champion Belt is kind of like a no-brainer pickup because it gives us extra damage. And I think we were already having Champion spawn anyway, so it's pretty much just like a damage upgrade for the damage upgrade's sake, which is something that I can very much get down with. Really? Like, how do I... There we go. Thread the needle on this one. You know what? We should probably stop this. But I'm not doing it. Let's move down to the next floor. I'm not sure how to feel about this run, honestly, but I do know that all we have to do, at first at least, is beat Mom, and then that counts as something new. Then all we do is something borrowed, something blue, and then we got the whole, world in our hands, you know? Man, these... Maybe bombs actually don't scale with damage? Because we picked up, like, 2 damage upgrades. Maybe 3, depending on how Brimstone is counted. And these enemies are still kind of effing with us. I don't know. I kind of like the changes to Fetus in a Jar. I kind of like that it isn't just a guaranteed win anymore. Don't even give me that bullshit, by the way. It wasn't a guaranteed win before. It was a guaranteed win in vanilla. Stop sandbagging. If you got Fetus in a Jar, it was basically just like, your run is done. Oh, great. A health downgrade. That's fantastic. Secret room? I don't think that's a secret room. We would have found it. We will be taking advantage of our mob trap room for sure. Desperately needing some more HP. Well, the good news is an HP downgrade on a floor with a bunch of mushrooms is not that bad, because we have a pretty good chance of getting an HP upgrade out of those HP downgrades. Key, please. Alright, just a lot of money. Can't really say that this is, you know, hard mode fucking us over and giving us a lack of keys, because this is the first run we've done in hard mode, but it certainly feels like that's an easy scapegoat for right now. That's a little scary. That might not get you. Didn't get you. That won't get you. This'll get you. One more. Ah, this guy. I'm still very surprised that this guy takes 3 hits to kill with the damage that we do in our bombs here. A little frightening. I wonder if there's like new boss patterns or something, because again, like, the pin fight seemed pretty samey, but I thought that Blue Famine had less of a tell than normal, but maybe like I'm so used to fighting Blue Famine that I just didn't pay any attention to it whatsoever. That was really bad, by the way, in case you didn't notice. By the way, I'm really loving how, wait, he died in one hit? I was really loving, though, how, it was apparently impossible to deal damage to that individual. This would be where our secret room is. Okay, that one of those would have found it for sure. Big room. Ah, it's just the dingles. Doesn't really bother me, but we are a little bit low on the... Ooh, a little bit low on the HP spectrum here. Scares me a great deal. I found pills. That is not really something we could be too excited about. Don't you put it in your mouth. You know the PSA. It's weird, I see that sometimes online, and the YouTube title for it is like, creepiest PSA ever, and it's like this animatronic fucking cat, and it's like, don't you put it in your mouth. And I'm like, man, I grew up with that shit. That explains a lot about me personally, I think. That was like my formative experience. Hey, a tears upgrade. Lovely. Not really what we need right now. There's our secret room. We'll bomb the sides just to see if maybe there's a chance at us getting into a special. Oh, we got into our shop for free. That's not our shop. This is just a random like interstitial room. The cards are okay. Wouldn't you agree? Where's our temperance card? Did I push it all the way over here? Okay, we'll put our temperance card down. And I really just want this to pay out, of course. But we can also explode it later. That champion actually dropped something, which is blowing my mind right now, to be honest with you. How many bad pills are in our rotation that we haven't seen yet? Like, this is crazy to me. There's a lot of stuff, you know, from all of our childhoods that was scary, but we just didn't realize it because we were young, I think. You know, and think back, like, how could it not be creepy, you know? Like, every freaking movie is just made up of talking animals. That's like the creepiest shit of all time. Like babies and animals that have intellectual capabilities they shouldn't have is like the basis for half of all, like, creepypasta. I don't, by the way, I feel weird using that term because I don't fully know what it is, but sometimes I find myself on, you know, No Sleep or, oh, No Sleep, the subreddit, not the state of mind. And I'm like, is this creepypasta? There's some creepy stuff going on here. We have Curse of the Blind. This is lovely. Habit. Oh, so it's Nun's Habit. Okay. That's great. I'm glad I picked it up there. We still have no keys in our shop, which to me, now I'm starting to feel like there's some kind of incredible conspiracy afoot here. Another, okay, pills, Liberty Cap. Feel like we've been pretty good on money so far. I would rather maybe have Liberty Cap, I don't know. Tears upgrade, don't mind if I already did, and amnesia, as if we needed anything else annoying on this floor. Second secret room is actually gonna give us an Eternal Heart, which I think we can totally be reasonably assuming to protect here. Well, double pin, oh my god, I can't believe I didn't get hit there. In some ways, double pin is very good, because if they get in sync with one another, my life becomes a lot easier. I hate the way they bounce these bombs. Oh my god! Are you seeing this shit? Well, most of all, I hate the way I don't hate them. Not even a little, not even at all. Is that what you were waiting for? There it is. What is your body made of? Fucking, like, a rubber band or something like that? You're rubber banding harder than Mario Kart right here. We might not explore too much of this floor after this. Which will mean, hey, we'll just not go to any item rooms, I guess, in this entire run, except for the first one. Lovely. Well, we did get a deal with the devil. That is a tears upgrade. Lovely. And we're gonna be fighting against Krampus himself here. If it's Lump of Coal, I guess we'll take it. If it's anything else, I guess we'll re-roll it. And by anything else, I mean the only other thing it could be is Krampus's head, but I don't know if Lump of Coal actually affects Dr. Fetus. Maybe we're better off just taking, just re-rolling whatever he gives us. Because we're not going to know what it is the first crack anyway, right? Let's re-roll it just for shits and giggles. We got Guppy's Hairball. Hey, gives us a small chance to become Guppy. Is it better or worse than Lump of Coal? I don't know, maybe like pretty similar. Well, we're not going to gamble on our blood bank anymore. We've been up here. I think we've been up here, so we should try to go down. I didn't even see an item room here. I know there's a curse room. I'm completely lost, which is fine. It happens. Okay, so we've been down here. Yeah, I think we maybe started over here. It sounds like there's a... Oh, this is where we fought a mini-boss. I was wondering why the music changed. Man, the amnesia pill fucks with you. I feel like I'm on some kind of weird, like, peyote trip or something like this. Like, I've been here before, but I don't understand what I'm seeing. Okay, well, you're gonna get exploded. Straight up. That, Spirit Heart is good for us. What's better? Lovers? Wheel of Fortune? You know what? We should actually pop down this Wheel of Fortune card. Over here. And I thought we had, yeah, we have, like, a High Priestess card too, though, right? Lovers? High Priestess. I think High Priestess is a little bit better than a Lover's card for us right now. Please allow me to retrieve a key out of this. I would desire it greatly. Okay, I mean the bombs... I'm not gonna poo-poo the bombs, because that sounds like it would leave a little bit of a mess in my toilet, but still. Like a single key might help me out a little bit here. All for the privilege of being able to enter the item room, which might have a shit item to begin with. Hopefully we have enough money left over, if that happens, to buy a battery from the shop. This is kind of absurd. That's alright. It's not like we've had luck upgrades or anything like that, so I'm not feeling like too ripped off, but still. Work with me here, game. I work with you, you work with me. If I could do this over again, by the way, I would... I'm gonna blow this up now. Ah, it worked! Okay, so we do have a battery left over to be able to, nothing over there. To be able to pick up a... Sorry, we have 5 cents left over to be able to pick up a battery if we want to. If our item room ends up being shitty. So finally, we've discovered El fucking Dorado over here, the City of Gold. Well, we haven't discovered the item room yet, but we can assume that it's over here. Felt like I was taking crazy pills for a minute there. Please be worth my time. That's all I can really ask. Sure, yeah, I bet you don't explode in one hit, because that would be way too easy. The sun. Oh, right, we don't know what it is. The virus, well, we've picked it up. And honestly, it's not so bad. I don't know if it was worth the incredible journey we went through, homeward fucking bound, just to get it, but here we are. You know, animals in movies, they always freak me out. Not on the same tangent of creepiness, but like that animal, has no fucking idea what's going on. It's like what I'm thinking about Grumpy Cat, right? I believe that the owners have Grumpy Cat. They think they have Grumpy Cat's best interests in mind. I really do. I think they think their cat is cute, and they're happy that Grumpy Cat is being shared with the world, and he's bringing joy to people. And isn't that what's important? Sure, maybe. But also, that cat is just like, what the fuck is going on? Like, do you think that cat's spoiled? I don't think that cat's spoiled, if I had to guess. I think it's just like, it's a cat, you know? But that cat makes the owners more money than, like... You know, all I can think of is, like, if you work in, like, a fucking coal mine or something like that. And then you're like, well, in other news, Grumpy Cat made, you know, its owners $8 million this year. And you go, like, I pull the coal out of the earth. That, you know, powers your homes and heats them and, you know, you use it for fuel and electricity. And then this cat, the cat doesn't even do, it doesn't know what it's doing at all. I mean, I'm not even saying it's injustice because it's obviously by popular demand. I'm just, how do you reconcile that? I guess that's the same for any kind of entertainer. You could even say that for someone like, I'll take it. For someone like me, if you're, you know... Coal miner might look at someone like me and be like, hey, this guy, why does he get paid, you know, maybe, I don't know how much a coal miner makes. They might make hundreds of thousands of dollars, but I don't know. It's weird, man. It's weirder when it's a cat, though, I think. It's best not to get into it, I guess, but it doesn't bum me out because, again, it's based on, you know, popular demand. What is wrong with my ability to speak today? It's based on popular demand. If 100,000 people want to go out and see this cat and shake its hand in Times Square, then I guess, you know, more power to the owners. But what a weird world we live in, where you know, one of the biggest celebrities is a cat. Maybe. I don't know, man. What am I talking about? I'm sitting here playing video games. Talking shit about, maybe Guppy Cat works harder. Guppy Cat? What is wrong with me? Maybe Grumpy Cat works harder than I do. Maybe Grumpy Cat actually is, like, incredibly intelligent. Maybe Grumpy Cat is a fucking robot that is, you know, made by Cyberdyne Systems, you know? And it's actually incredibly intelligent, but it's sent here to erode my faith in mankind so I can't become the savior that man needs in their time of need. Great diction on that one, by the way. So we're fighting Dark One. Dark One ain't so bad. Most important thing, though, is you don't stand directly below him. Instead, you kind of, you know, straddle the line with discord and rhyme. I'm on the hunt, I'm after you. That's a little Duran Duran reference for all you, you know, Generation Xers out there. Duran Duran might be a little bit old for Generation X. Great karaoke song, though. Don't question it. So Dark One's actually pretty easy. We have Curse of the Unknown. That scares the crap out of me, but I'm not too worried about it as long as... Oh, Little Steven! Okay, that is just... Lovely for us. I suppose I should have re-rolled that. I'm still... I don't know. My re-roll foo is not fully where it belongs. I actually kind of like Little Steven. I'm not sure if it's going to be very, you know, worthwhile with what we've got going on, though. Wait. I've been to the item room. Okay, yeah, I have been to the item room. It was Sticky Ball of Tar. Which is pretty good. You know, anything that generates a little bit of creep, no problems there. These guys are a little bit more resilient than I think they have any right to be right now. Insubordinate and churlish. Do you have anything for me in this room? Anything of value? Yeah, okay. That is valuable. Those keys are incredibly useful. Strangely enough. I don't think this run has very good chances of making it, you know, down to the dark room. I get confused because... Mathis calls it the Nega Chest. Because you pick up the negative to go there. And I'm like, why don't you just call it the Dark Room like you're a normal person? He's like, well, you pick up the negative to go there, so that's what I call it. I'm like, man, why you gotta be such a jerk about it? It's pretty much how, that's how all of our conversations end. And then I mock him for having like a negative 8 streak in Rebirth. And he says, yeah, well, why don't you 1v1 me in StarCraft 2? And I say, I don't even own StarCraft 2. And he says, well, I'll buy it for you so I can beat you up. And I say, no, because I would feel uncomfortable with that level of generosity from a personal friend. But I'm not going to buy it myself because I don't want to play it. We have riveting and intense conversations, as you can tell. But yes, I like our chances of beating Mom. Sort of. I can't take two hits against Super Pride. Like, it would just make me so sad. I'm just gonna blow this up because I can't be trusted with Curse of the Unknown to actually play that appropriately. I knew we had a few plays to kind of be safe there, but why risk it, is my opinion. But yeah, I think we've got a pretty okay chance of beating Mom, although it's pretty hard to actually... There's BFF. Chat's gonna go wild over that one. So let's buy BFF and then reroll the Bible. It gets rerolled into the map, which I think is not very good, but I'll take it anyway. Oh, people come out of the woodwork sometimes. They say, Northern Lion, you don't do, you don't give the map enough respect. I totally agree with that, by the way. But I know myself as well, and you know, with the map kind of confined to that corner of the screen, can't see the whole thing at once unless you go for that overlay that I find a little bit restrictive. I prefer to, have the compass. That's okay, though. Nothing necessarily to write home about. This is actually, like, a pretty... Just, I wouldn't say classic run, because we got, you know, nerfed Dr. Fetus here. But it's like a pretty normal run. We do a normal amount of damage. We have probably a slightly less than normal chance of, slightly less than normal amount of HP. But other than that, like, it's been pretty dang normal. We're only on the depths part one. Man, okay, we do have definitely a lower than normal amount of HP. This room, by the way, scares the shit out of me. Anytime you're in, you know, tight spaces here, you gotta be careful. Where's my hairball? Thank you. I'm actually very thankful that we... I'll take it. I know it's, you know, not necessarily the best play for us, but what else are we gonna do? Like, try to do the, you know, the foxtrot around these guys until they, allowed me to kill them without picking up the battery? I'm not too concerned about it. We got bigger fish to fry right now. That looks like the perfect secret room to me, right down here. It's even gated by like two skulls around it. That's like some Lord of the Rings shit. Oh, I didn't mean to do that, but thank you for giving me a key in return, secret room. And then a little bit of money on the flip side there. Balls of steel, that's a pretty useful situation for us to find ourselves in here. Nothing special down here. How about down here? Item room? Shop? Okay, it's a curse room. This could actually be better than any of those combined. We got a speed down and an I found pills, but we did pick up a spirit heart at least. That's worth something in and of itself. Alright, we have a special item room here. The hairball got the kill there, which is actually pretty impressive. I really wish that Brimstone had overridden... probably not. I really wish that Brimstone had overridden Dr. Fetus, but that's okay. Honestly, I think Aquarius is pretty good as well. It's not, well, you should take the sun. It's not the best item in the game. I don't know what really gives us the win here, by the way. I guess it would have to be something like Mr. Mega. There's our shop over here. With one key, I'm a little wary about going to it, because we do still have, you know, an item room available on the next floor. That, we could definitely use a key for. I guess we'll play it by ear if our, if our finances hold out, maybe we'll go to the shop. If they don't, then we won't. But it is worth noting, you know, we could fairly conceivably fight greed in our shop, which is actually something that I find quite desirable. I would also love to see maybe some more defensive items. You know, Holy Mantle would be a nice pickup. That does show up in item rooms. The Relic shows up in item rooms from time to time, I think. For now, I'm very distracted by the fact that I'm on hard mode, though. I gotta admit, I'm a little intimidated. Is there ever a TV show called Intimidate? And it would be like really physically kind of small statured men who have a fetish for female bodybuilders, and they go out on like a reality show style like dating game with them. That would be awesome. I know there's a Elimidate, but I think they haven't exhausted like all of the wordplay that they can possibly get out of that one concept, you know? Intimidate. Irradiate? That doesn't really work. I don't know even what would that would be. It would be like nuclear scientists trying to find love in a post-Chernobyl universe. Now. We're still engaging in the fine art of exploration here. Trying to find a second secret room. I guess that guy's just gonna chill down there, which is fine by me. You do what you gotta do. Any enemies that jump, they get screwed super hard by Aquarius, so I can dig it. Now, you guys would just form a, you know, single file queue. Oh, okay, that was my bad. Not all dead. Still this guy right here. Two bombs. Still not dead. Maybe he is dead and it's just the skull that I have to take care of. Alright, it was. So just seeing, we'll blow up the skulls. We might as well shoot blue fires as well, just to see. Hey, Tomo. Can you hear that? I think you probably can hear that. High Priestess. Well, we're on Depths 1, so maybe... I don't want to talk about that. Maybe we'll take High Priestess into our boss fight. The stars. Ah, the stars is so good for us. Because of the fact that we, you know, we have a key shortage, but... I don't think it's worth giving up the sun card. Like, either short or long term. That was bad damage, I'll just readily admit that. No reason to try to act like that was good at all. Don't think we'll be going to our shop here. If we can get a deal with the devil, we will have rerolls available to use on it. What is this slow? Oh my god, that was a terrible shot. And then I walked over there, creep. I hate when you have creep because it does make it, you know, I don't know. For me, it makes it a little harder to be cognizant of the enemy creep. Now, I should be looking for second secret rooms as well, but I'm kind of distracted by Freddy fucking Krueger here on my back door. That's the real terror, Tomo, is this scratching noise. I'll tell you what, buddy, I'll let you in. Because on videos where there's a cat, I learned this at YouTube Creator Academy, there's a 65% greater engagement on average. That's a statistic I just made up. Don't look it up.
Tomo, buddy. Come on in, dog. You're waiting here. Come on in. You want to come in too, Ruka? You got 5 seconds. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, go. That was not 5 seconds. But
my cats don't have a very accurate internal clock, probably. Cartridge. Cartridge can be okay. I kind of like Liberty Cap, though. It's like a warm hug. Oh, this is going to be bad. Actually, one cage on a decent-sized room is not terrible. I'm having flashbacks, so we should not fire as quickly as we can. It's one of the... Just because we can doesn't mean we should in this situation. If we got, like, a pretty decent set... No, you know what? We really should time our bombs more cognizantly, consciously than that. If we fire as fast as we can, the bombs end up, like, interacting with one another, which is very bad for my business. But we should get a deal with the devil here. We've earned one. I think. Speed upgrade. That could be rerolled. And the ability to fly. I'm gonna go a little silly here. We're gonna take this and reroll this, hope for HP. That's exactly how that went down. It might seem like I have a death wish, but to be honest with you, I think the ability to fly is actually a pretty okay pickup for us. Even at that relatively cost prohibitive... Not that. Even at that relatively cost prohibitive level, I think it's going to be pretty good for me. We don't have a very good chance of surviving into the late game, but I think we can at least beat Mom here. And for a first, you know, hard mode attempt... I took the Stars card instead of the Sun card! I did the same freaking thing, but oh well, because now we can use it, and truth be told, it's alright. Truth be told, I don't think the sun card is going to be too effective for us when we only have 1 HP anyway, but do the bombs actually home? It doesn't look like they home at all. Hey, Dry Baby for free is pretty good. Now, if we're going to have any chance of, like, I'm not giving up on our long-term chances here, but if we're going to have any chance of making this run work, we're going to have to be very vigilant about things like shooting these skulls. Looking for tinted rocks, stuff like that as well. At least it makes our bombs look cool. Chariot card? That is another one that might be more valuable than the sun, honestly. Okay, Tomo. I let you in. Now you do your best to traverse the... difficulties of the desk here. Come on, dog. What are you doing here? Hey! You get in there. You don't play on the desk when I'm recording. You get into the window, okay? He's got a difficult journey in front of him. The curtain's closed, so he's gonna have to figure out like the hardest puzzle in cat history here. I wanna make like a Tomo Lemmywink song for him. Oh, they do home. It's kind of a subtle effect on that first room, at least. Man, these guys take a lot of hits. Fetus Ingeniaria, it ain't what it used to be, ain't what it used to be, ain't what it used to be. Fetus in a jar went from great to kinda shitty, that's what I'm singing today. Oh, this is, the Cousins Dangerous right here. I mean, they've got like a, I said the homing was subtle. That is not correct. I've totally forgot that I could fly, by the way. Alright, let's play smarter now. I've determined that one of the principal determining factors in me not having very much HP right now is the fact that I'm playing like a shit dog. That's a word that I've just invented, but I think its meaning is pretty much self-evident. Man, the bombs really gain a lot of speed once they start homing here. It's kind of crazy. We're gonna go to our shop. After that, we'll make... so bad. We'll make a judgment call about whether or not I want to explore the rest of the floor. I love the idea that there's these skulls around. I love Mom's key, I guess. I can enjoy it at least. Give you a little extra cash here. I think we're just going to go straight for the boss fight because we have our reroll prepared. It's a little bit of a lazy play, I'll admit, but I'm not doing it out of inherent laziness, more because I wanna strike while the iron's hot. We got our reroll available, we got a chariot card. Who's got a chariot card? Yes, we do. Who's got a chariot card? How about you? Okay, we're doing next to no damage here. That's fairly obvious, I think. That was terrible as well. The most damage we've done is via one black card exploding. We do have our chariot card, but I think we can fairly realistically expect to beat Mom without it. So we beat Mom without the use of our chariot card. Then we use it on preferably Mom's heart, and we get a little bit more unlocked on our first run here. If there even are unlocks specifically for these fairly simple challenges on hard mode. I don't know. There may or may not be. Trying to stay away here, but I also want to hit the foot with my delicious orbital action if I can. Also feel like Mom is spawning like three times as many enemies as she normally does. One more hit will kill us, I think. Dry baby! Dry baby! The greatest! Right, we don't want to have a reroll anyway. Okay, down to the next floor. At least we do have 2 HP. Allow me to caffeinate here. We did not get any unlock there at all. And notice, Curse of the Unknown. That's sweet as heck. So we're just going to have to, luckily with Curse of the Unknown, it's kind of easy for us to tell how much HP we have. We have 2. So let's just keep that number in mind. I get that it's kind of a tough one. Thank you, Dry Baby. Take me in and dry the babe. Take me in and dry the babe. That's the hottest beta band reference you'll find on YouTube today. I guarantee you that. Where are we going to go here? What are we going to do with our shit once we get there? I don't know. We got a lot of problems on this run. Do we get more curses on hard runs as well? Is that part of the deal? Amnesia. Balls of Steel, that's big. So now we have 4 HP. Remember that. James West, Tame in the West, so remember the name. Now who are you going to call? Not the GBs. Who are you going to call? J-Dub and AG. I don't know. Wait, now we got 3 HP because apparently I hit the button by accident. If you have a rift with people want to bust, break out before you get bum rushed. Can someone perhaps explain to me what is bum rushing? I thought it was when, because it sounds dirty, but you know, I'm gonna stay away from the obvious, you know, very juvenile joke, which I don't like to do on this channel. This is more of a cerebral kind of, you know, video game let's play content. You know, I thought it was like when people rush your bum, but not for like sexual purposes. You know what I mean? Now the cat is trying to escape from the room. This must be the greatest video game of all time for this cat. Maybe he just likes fucking with me, I don't know. But why say bum rush? Why not just say rush? Bum rush has a little bit more, I don't know, poetic flavor or something like that? I don't buy it. Plus, if you just say rush, then that makes me think of like Geddy Lee, which is awesome. And any chance I get on a daily basis to think of Geddy Lee, pretty much fulfilling my requirements of being a patriotic Canadian. All right, Tomo, buddy, you having a breakdown there? breakdowns come, breakdowns go. What are you gonna do about it? That's what I'd like to know. One sec here.
Okay, seriously, dog. You gotta calm your shit down, Tomo. Well, you made it. You escaped.
I love him. What a cat. What a character. I think it's because Kate was in the shower, so he's like, I want to be in that room, because Ryan's not in the shower right now. Oh, that was a bomb, not a rock. And then, I think we have 2 HP now. And then, she got out of the shower, and I just killed myself with bombs. I'm so mad. What a throw at the end of that run. But at least, we can look at I can blame my cat for that one. Don't we have... Oh, we didn't kill the heart, so we didn't even fill up the poster note. Well, that was a rude fucking awakening on hard mode. I think we've learned a little bit, you know, we got ourselves orientated a little bit. I'm gonna record another one here, hopefully without the distraction of a cat, not that I blame it, and maybe a little bit more normal tears as well. But in any case, thanks for watching, I apologize for that terrible throw at the end there. Rate of fire with Fetus in a jar, or sorry, Dr. Fetus is just annoying. Anyway, we'll be back. Thanks for watching, my apologies, and I'll see you next time.